Okay, so currently I have finished up. Took like an extra half hour to get all this stuff done for the pipeline. Figuring out what I needed where. Very annoying. These aren't even enabled, anyways. No depth testing whatsoever. Pointless. What was I doing? I needed the other functions. Of course, all these other. These. Well, not that many, actually. Okay, close to the right. Close to the right. Close that up. Do, 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 do. Up, 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 up. Initialize. Yeah. Deinitialize. No, this is initialization still. Deinitialized, initialized. So what I've got these guys. So, new frame is easy enough. It's effectively just a pass through. Oh, I need to be able to update as well, actually. Actually, yeah, so I need to be able to grab the or set the index and vertex buffer stuff first. I need a set of buffers, basically, like count size, count size, 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 probably actually. Down, 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 push constant block. Well, I need a number of like a an array. I could probably do a vector. Buffer set. Buffer. No, draw set would have to be like. Yeah, okay, hold on. Vertices and indices. Then we take this draw set. We have a set of these guys. Include a vector for the moment, anyways. We'll have to actually, when we're deinitializing, we'll have to come through after everything else and effectively same thing, but for indices. Don't need to clear them because we're just clearing the entire vector at the end of it. Then down here, we're going to have to actually create them and fill them up with the information that we require. So, buffered frame. Okay, what we're going to do is buffer, oh, draw buffer set. Make a reference to, okay, no. First of all, make sure it's large enough for what we need. So M draw buffers, right? If it's less than size, if the size is less than or equal, then we need to increase it by one. It's not being highlighted because of that. There we go. Okay. Just an empty one. Just add it to the end. Sure, it's size plus one. Simple enough. Then buffered frame vertices. Do the same thing for indices. This sorry, not that, false equals false. We want to do if probably want to actually do like a bool, some form of feedback. If there was even anything to update. Will vertex count? That. Total index count times size of draw index. Okay, yeah. Vertex, vertices. Size count. Do I not have the environment with me? I don't. Oh, but I do have the allocator. Yeah, that's right. That's what I need. Right now, it's just every time it changes, I'm going to just do recreate it. Not the greatest, but. I'm just not even going to bother transferring it. It's just going to be straight. Of course we'd have to return something you... To be doubly sure, we should always... Okay. Whatever. Return if there's no problem. Do I even... I don't need a transfer, do I? No, I would have to, yeah, after this stuff. No, I wouldn't even have to transfer. I just copy the data in. That's it. Result. Okay, then vertex count. Vertices. Allocator, the buffer CI, the alloc CI, the pointer. There we go. Basically, same thing, but for indices. Indices. Total index count. Index. Buffer size. Indices. Total index count. Indices. Okay. I got all this. So now we want to actually throw the data in. Yeah, do it all together. That we'd have. going. Copy. Destination P, P vertex data. What is with this weird variable naming scheme? Capitalization. Ugh. What are you doing? Meme copy. Not quite. Okay, we've updated all the stuff. Drawing. Where am I? I lost me here. First thing, we do want these. We don't need to return VK result because that'll be done by the command buffer itself on the completion of it. Actually, can we also const that up here? No, we already did. Wait, hold on. I already have this up here. Oh, it's the draw list, right? GUI is using ints. Oh well. If if there's nothing to draw, there's nothing to draw. Leave out. Point. We have the one. Endpoint graphics. The layout. We have 0. We have 1. Is there even a point to me actually keeping this around if I'm just refilling it every time? No, there's not. In fact, there's just no point in me even having it in here when I just throw it in here. So I don't even need GLM up here, I just need it in here. What time? What kind do you use? Index type UN16. Okay. Depends. So I don't. Okay, I see. It's the size of this thing. So it's a constant type. Interesting. Okay. Going on here. Index type, okay. Buffer, oh. It's always just one, and then one offset. Actually, yeah, that's true. If I, yeah. I don't need GLM whatsoever for this. We can just do that instead. Woo-wee. Here we go. And then we'll have another problem down here as well. So it's the size of four floats. One, two, three, four, yeah. This, so it's this, negative one, like that. Oh, I'm missing the draw data as well. Minus one. No, I don't need this. Negative one is always going to be in the top left corner. That's because it's assuming otherwise it'd be a 0, 0 instead of negative one, negative one. So translation, yeah. Okay, let's, what's we got going on here? Render draw data. Okay, then we gotta go through the command list. Okay, we need to, we've got the scissor and then we've got the rectangle. Okay, yeah. Rect 2D. Okay. No, it's size. I want to actually move this down here. Okay, that's that. I'm gonna need the ability to resize, obviously. rescale. I'll need to do mouse and stuff input as well. Later. First of all, we've got this, we've got the draw, then it goes into the initialize. Okay, so we'll just do like. You know, I could just get it as float, right? Just auto convert to float wherever the hell you get in this and just do this. Because that's the type I'm actually accepting. That's the type that it accepts, I should say. Is there anything in here? No. Search it. What's this about? It's probably this. This is what I'm looking for. Frame buffer scale. Okay, so this is some. And this will probably. I don't have Mac to test on. I'll assume though. Some point. Okay, now I need to do input for the other items. Just do both. What am I doing? then we're going to need a few other items. We need to see if we even want to capture the mouse. Oh, no. That's true. I want to be able to do them individually. Okay. If we want to capture the mouse, then we don't want to pass it to the rest of the application. Because it's being used for UI stuff right now. And same thing on the mouse, on the keyboard. Keyboard. Do we want even the cat? Okay. Five. For each of the buttons that are currently held down, mouse down. horizontal. For mouse buttons, position the scroll wheel. Yeah. Do I need to reset? No. Keys down. It's only got a key down set. So keys down equals true. Oh, dang. Actually, no, that'd be a bad idea in case it's reset across things. It's not keys down, it's pressed key. Okay, which one was it? It's starting to become a bit foggy. It's been long enough. Held keys. Down keys. Okay, so just reset it and it just becomes down keys. Keys down. All the rest stays false every time. Character is greater than 0, and less than, like, actually I don't even know, like, just greater than 0. Actually, maybe I should just double check what they got on the back end for GLFW. GLFW, keys down. Okay. Just add input. Okay. Unsigned in? Yeah, okay, that makes sense. About those, don't need this, we just want to have it here somewhere. Same thing for this, really. Do we even need the vector anymore? Yes, we do. Got the environment here. Nearly 800, just over 800 lines worth of stuff. I hope it's going to work. I mean, I've made a number of changes compared to their implementation. Right, let's see what happens. GHI, do that, we add it in, got the engine. Oh, that no, it should be added. Undefined reference. Maybe it has to be static. Or fpic. Set definition. I don't know. Ooh. No, not a definition. Compile option. Nope, still undefined. Wait, okay. Do I even include ImGui on that one? Yeah. Yeah, I do. It's not like they're not declared. We do have them declared. It's not like that. I'm definitely including this. He's built. He's right here. He's brought in there. Okay, what if he's static? What if he's static? Okay, he finds most of it. Add subdirectory. Okay. He's added. All these guys are added. I don't know. I do not know. This is Unix. So, all right, if I remove him, then he's recompiled because he's new. Yeah. Okay, does it really matter if it's static or not? You know what, just set it to static. It's something going for the dev side anyways. Make it a bit easier. Okay, graphics. We got something to do with the image. Is it the image or the upload data? Gotta export that function. Okay. Now let's just make a test UI. Okay, I need to include that as well while I'm here. Okay. See that that it's auto resizes, and that was that ImGui end. Okay, test UI. Okay. Guess we'll just kind of put it at the end here, kind of. No, I didn't need crap. I need the render pass and stuff. Yeah. Okay, where do I have the render pass and stuff set already? Here? Or it's not really until way down here, right? I create the swap chain. Render pass. It's not until way down here. God, the queues. The queues! I don't know them. Oh, right. I don't even need them right now either. I didn't even use them. Not quite yet. Not great. Not great at all. No, I can resize the ImGui stuff around here. Somewhere. Before, okay, resize before we even do anything crazy. Yeah. Yeah. So I need to grab the width and height. Like that. Pass width and height. Okay, now we have this stuff. Resized. We resized, then we do. Because the X and Y is based on the new width and height. Actually, would it? It doesn't really matter, does it? Could it be like down here? I'll leave it there for the moment. Do all this. Almost ended. We don't end the render pass quite yet because we draw the stuff and then we want to do. Drew it, I got all that stuff, and then we want to, inside of this queue, we'd want to update it. Which requires, what was it? The allocator. And the buffered frame, so frame index. The errors. I didn't even export any of these, did I? I expect failure. But where is the question? Perfect. Invalid display size was blah 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 blah. Invalid display size. Why? Where? At what point? Main? Here. ImGui Renderer has invalid display size of. What was it? -1 and -1, really, still. Did I not call? Because it was it wasn't resized, it started off with. Interesting. We're in the test UI. Pushing in a style var that does not want to accept. Okay, what is this other stuff? Okay, I'll come back to this in a moment. What's this exactly? It's just nothing. The global is nothing, really. I thought it would have been initialized via this, right? This is called, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. We do have context. So we haven't destroyed it either, right? Accidentally. Not yet. Because this is definitely way after. I mean, we have initialized it, right? Well, we've initialized the Vulkan stuff, yeah. Maybe it's something to do. No, I wouldn't. Because we've created the new frame to start with. That was fine. Start a new frame. Then we go in here. This is just freaking nowhere. Maybe I need to position independent code anyways on Unix. Maybe. A global type, maybe it needs position independent stuff. Nope, that's nothing to do with it at all. It's just not. Okay, let's see what we got going on in their little items. Let's just find any. I'm not looking. No, can I not do like a specific case type? Ah, that's pretty terrible. Okay. I'm going to. This is just a whole bunch of stuff of Vulkan, not actually for. Okay, here we go. Create context. That's it. It's just style, color. Maybe I'm missing style? Got the style. I've set it all. Got the IO, I've set the scales. Not sure why, like, okay. This thing is just, I don't, why is this thing what it is? Like, is there not an equals context? Okay, this. Set current context, create context. If that, okay. I definitely come through here. I do, I'm. I create context. If it's null, which it is, we then set it. That's great. The context is now created. That's fantastic. That is the same as that. We never destroy it. Wait, hold on, what? And then we come to here and gonna die because now it's not. Where is this? Where is it going? Where is it? Okay. Let's do position independent code. First of all, let's make sure it's position independent code. For okay, yeah, it's independent. Wait, is it because I'm doing visibility hidden on this type, so it's hide. Ooh, actually, interesting. What if I brought external above the point where I set these guys for the export stuff? That was it. Now I'm on to a different problem. Okay. What do I do for externals? Yeah, just put them, okay, we'll just libraries. Okay, no. Visible, hidden zero. For externals, right? Or no, it's default. Default and zero. That should also mean we may not actually be, we may be able to do this as well. Because now the objects aren't hidden by default. They should be visible all the time. Almost. We got the triangle. We do have the triangle. Drawing straight to the buffer. Interestingly, actually. Anyways, where was I? Mapping my malloc as where? What part? When we're doing this, when we're mapping vertices allocation to this, we're running into issues. Okay, but we already have issues from down here as well. So let's figure this out first. So, yes. Okay, you're in here somewhere. So what exactly do we have in here then? Start. Hope. Nope. And so basically it has to be something inside of here. And there's only one way to figure it out. And oh, okay, maybe not. It will actually do it again. See exactly where it happens. Okay, so this is, the copying is where all the nastiness happens. Okay. What is the image sub-resource? Actually, then, did I screw that up? That's a whole sub-resource range. Okay. I created the image here. It is that size. I've 64 to 1, okay. Image copy, the image extent, 512.64.1. Looks fine. Okay. Sub-resource range. Okay. Regions image offset.x, image copy. Must be greater than 2 equal. Yeah. P copy regions. Image sub resource. Am I? Because, wait, do I have the wrong MIP level? MIP level equals 1. Base. No, it must be the one MIP level, the actual MIP level, which is 0. Ooh. Not one, jeez. Right? It's not like this where it has base MIP level and the number of MIP levels. We're actually, it is the specific MIP level that we're looking at. Yeah, we're in the right one. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now we have something else anyways. We have a seg fault here instead. Great! So what's... Well, we'll see what happens when we come through here again. Okay. There's none. We create one. Two, actually. Because we're starting on, what, frame index of 1. Empty and empty. Why do I even have his? Gone now anyways. Anyways. Back to this. We Come in, we're doing this. It's fantastic. It's both. There's just nothing to do here. Nothing to draw. We just go carry on. Come back. $1,300 and $318. So it wasn't on the first frame. It's on the second frame. Okay, we create one. Successfully. Vertices count is 90. Same thing for indices. We map it. We don't map this one. Did I miss something? Indices buffer, indices alloc? Interesting. It's definitely not the same as the vertices one. Why is it going on about this one? What's different? Is this size zero or something? No, there's definitely a real size. There's 159 indices and 90 vertices. 159 times 2. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. We created it successfully. We map the one, and then we try to map the other, and then it fails. Can I not just map both at the same time? First allocate. Is there any vertices that I accidentally left in here? No. Okay. What? Am I running into like... Okay, what if I swap them around? What? happens. Wait, I'm what? It's static. It's on the indices one again. Why? And why is it being part of Lipfographics instead of its own library? I'm seriously confused. I thought it is static. What if it wasn't? Now he's his own separate library. But he's still doing it on the indices. Still. Why does he hate the index buffer so much? Okay, first of all, index buffer bit. I am. Okay. I must be like just. What's frame index? 2. We only just created these buffers, and it can't even. Okay. You're just. Why? Why? It's not even like it's returning a result, it's just crashing. It's not even my library, it's theirs. Why is it just the indices? What if I swap the order that they're initialized in? We create the indices buffer before the vertex one. Does it now fail on the other one? No, it's the same damn one. Oh, you know what? I'm an idiot. I'm changing. Yeah. Wow. You know what? Yep. Just not even gonna. Hell yeah. We actually, whoa, look at those frame rates. 17,000. That can't be right. Okay, let's put it on the 4K. 5,000 on 4K. Okay. Okay. I'll take those numbers. Even with this. Now I gotta figure out the frame. I gotta figure out some kind of delayed destruction mechanism. To prevent deletion of items when they're still in use. But it actually worked without much in the way of issues. For something that's basically a fully reworked version of their implementation. Well, reworked as in it's working in my mechanism instead. Okay, let's see if we can do work this just a little bit. Okay, it goes before that. Do I really need an array? Why not? Why not? And in fact, if we already have an array there, we may as well just use it for that other type as well. I mean, I guess I could just leave it here saying, hey, you know, ImGui is implemented. Barely. Barely. But it is there. Hell yeah. Oh, yeah, I gotta remove this stuff. Destruction of necessary stuff. Okay, so it could be one of the last things that happens. Independent. Hey. Okay. Oh, wow. I got a lot of files here. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Do this. Stage that. Set as behavior. Okay. Next we'll add the ImGui library. Oh, whoa, hold on. Actually, undo that. Put it in a bloody branch. Okay, now ImGui to here. Yeah, I'm just assuming that this stuff is pretty good. Okay, make some modifications. That was a rename. Also got the upload data that was also made, moved to the public side. Updated. Header change, location change. Same thing for here. This one. Still not quite touching that one. Not touching that one. Okay. Change from private to public. exported. Okay, right. Added the exports. Slightly modified that. Exported. Moved header. Updated for splitting of the vector. Actually, if that's split, do I still need... I don't need vector here anymore. Whoops. Open the file. Because I split it from vector to actually pass in a pointer and then the count instead. Do I need I don't even need CMath here either, actually, because the functions or the definitions are now in the other file. What I do need is the Vulkan and the export, which they are here. Actually, if this is public as well, I need to change this to be like, to have the prefix as well. We want that and that. We want to do. Okay, need to update that. Make sure it's buildable. Not quite. Because I removed CMath from there, it needs to be in here instead. Okay, where do you come from? I thought you would be CMath, but... Pow. You're from CMath. What are you complaining about? I include you. No, I don't. Okay. That probably means the same thing on the other guy as well, right? Stencil? Yeah. Okay. That's that. Then we add the ImGui items. Actually, no, not these. We don't want to include these U32s. Okay. Got all this. We add the library. We add this. We also do not want to move this INI file with us. Then we add the renderer. Not sure if I actually want to add this quite yet. But I'll add the library, and then I'll add the implementation in the application. So we got this. Let's see. Yeah, new enough. What's that? 10, 11, 0? Okay. 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 Need to kind of make this a little neater. We're close to the end. So we deinitialize the render. We only have the one. Okay. We have it all right here. The update and the frame stuff is all right here. I really want to kind of have it split out as well. So I can have it compiled in or out depending on if it is actually yes. Yes. Along with here, we'll have the option for editor mode. Build with the editor. Elements and UI capability. Which is by default off, of course. So we can say if editor mode, then include this. I don't want to like implement a whole bunch of stuff and then have to start ripping it up, just ripping it from, you know, flesh from bone. It'd be like a painful experience. I'd rather get it done, separated it out now, and just make sure moving forward I keep it separate. So we'll use it a little easier to get it a little bit ahead of the curve. Okay, we have this. We want to add like a definition. Definitions. Be like D. Because this will be like dash D this. Right? Okay, hold on. Put it here and see what it comes out with in the file commands. Editor mode. It's not even there. Oh, because, yes, I didn't even add it. Okay, there we go. Editor mode, dash D editor mode. Yeah, it does add the dash D. Excellent. That means in here, where we have, okay, let's say, editor stuff. Ah, whatever. It's never compiled in. It's not even something we have to worry about ripping out for the final thing. pretty sure I want to do something about this new and end frame. Okay, well, let's just look at the demos for ImGui, just trying to think of something I can do. Actually, that's probably the best idea. Okay, what we can do, experimental, okay, whatever, text. Percent up to float milliseconds a frame, which is 0.1 float FPS millisecond per frame per second. And just kind of leave it at that. Okay, we go down to test UI, which is here, which would be like what per where is it? Where is it? It's around here somewhere. Okay. There's only six of them. Come on. There you are. So we take that out. Then it's this. I could do the next rate down, which would be like nanoseconds, but right now that's basically always zero. So we can actually probably just, we don't even need this next display time stuff then. Just if it's always, you know what, actually keep it for the second. Make sure it's actually going to display properly. Ridiculous number, yes. Okay. And it's probably going to increase if I get rid of this anyways. Where is it? There it is. Okay, 1 second. Okay, no, milliseconds to nanosecond. Equals, whoa, that's a lot of nanoseconds. So it's, divided by that. Divided by that, we'll take it 2 milliseconds. It'll still be like 0.0000 something. Actually, whoa, yeah, I need that to be double. If I want to actually. 0 time at all. And even if I put it on a big ass screen. Oh, it's not actually clearing out the number, is it? I don't know if it's like not clearing it out or it's just really so fast that. Nah, whatever. Oh, actually, that's something I could actually maybe think of is doing the icon. Right, because the icon is basically empty. That a little X, which is the default. Okay, commit this. Call it good with that one. Another 2 hours on that. Yeesh. Actually, one thing is for sure, we want to do that. Want to fix the frame counting mechanism. Okay, now we have all that's left is this stuff. This and this. Filter focused. Okay, I think I'll call it there for the moment. Yep. Cheers.